Shane, first of all, welcome in Athens. I would like to ask you, how do you guys manage to make a complete turnaround last year and from the bottom of the EuroLeague 2 years before, you fought for the title?
You know, we really just committed to each other, committed to our team. And we're very unselfish. You know, everybody bought into the system and we played for each other every single night. Nobody went out there and was looking for the individual statistics. Everybody was just trying to do whatever we could to win. And when you have a team that fights hard every single day, every single game, and fights together, it's hard to beat them. And I think that's what really helped us get to that level.
I'm sure that you heard some rumors about this stuff. I'm going to ask you. Your coach, Ergin Ataman, had a bad reputation, you know, in his relationship with the foreign players. Did you hear that before you signed? And, you know, how was the atmosphere in the team and which was your experience?
I think each coach's relationship with players is different. I don't think it matters where you're from. I think each coach gravitates towards certain players and each coach doesn't like coaching certain players. And I never had any issues with them. You know, early on in the season last year, I wasn't playing as much, but that was just because I wasn't playing good. So I don't think that had anything to do with our relationship. And I mean, I don't think anybody on our team has a bad relationship with them.
How do you see this EuroLeague, this new format with 18 teams, with 34 games, with 7 double weeks?
I mean, I like it. You know, it's always fun to play games. Nobody wants to have one game a week. So the times where we have double weeks is always fun. Obviously, your body's a little beat up, but you practice to play. So, you know, it's always fun to be able to go out there and play multiple games. And I like the new format. You know, my first year in Europe was the first year that it changed to the new format where you play everybody instead of the groups. And I think it's fun to be able to travel to all the countries, play all the teams in their home arenas.
Given the fact that last year you were the finalist, how tough do you think this year could be for you? Because every team wants to knock you out.
Yeah, I mean, you said it perfectly. Every team is going to be more energized to play against us. Whereas to last year, they were like, okay, they're a good team, but you know, there was no real excitement about playing Anadolu Efes last year.
Nobody expected you.
Exactly. Nobody expected
you. Now everybody expects you.
So now everybody knows who we are, knows our players, knows our coaches, knows our game, and everybody looks at us as like, all right, they're the team that finished in the final. They have pretty much the same roster. If we can knock them off, then we have a chance to go do what they did last year. So it's definitely going to be more challenging.
How do you see from your side the collaboration with Misic? You guys have formed, you know, a perfect duo so far. Last year also, but also this year.
I mean, I think we're just two guys that know how to play the game the right way. And we kind of play off of each other. And, you know, we have a good relationship on the court and off the court. So it really makes it easy to go out there and play together. And he can do a lot of things on the basketball court. I can do a lot of things. And we kind of just play off of each other. If he's having a good game or if he's hot, you know, we ride with him. We call the plays for him. If I'm having a good game, if I'm hot, we call the plays for me. And, you know, we have a lot of guys on our team we can do that for. But us being like the point guards out there, we kind of control the offense a lot of the time. And I think the more we play together, the better we're going to get, and we can be very dangerous.
How do you see Panathinaikos so far this year? And I think that Athens is a city that you never won before.
Yeah, I've never won here. I've never won here against Panathinaikos or Olympiacos. So looking forward to changing that tomorrow. And, you know, they're a great team. They have a lot of talent, a lot of size. A lot of scoring ability, and obviously they have one of the best point guards. So they're a great team. They are always right there, playoff team every year, and this year they look to be no different. So it looks like they have a lot of guys, added some NBA guys, added some other guys that can really score the ball from China. You know, Jimmer can really score the ball, some athletes, Tyrese Rice. So, you know, they're a very talented team, a very experienced team. And I'm sure they're going to be very hungry. You know, last year they were in the playoffs and they didn't get to go to the Final Four, and we did. So I think they're going to look at that challenge as like, you know, let's go take these guys out.
Something personal. Why did you choose basketball instead of baseball since your father was a Hall of Famer?
Basketball was just more exciting. You know, basketball globally is more receptive than baseball.
You played baseball when you were a kid?
When I was very young, I played it probably until I was 8 years old, then I never played again.
Do you think that the European style of basketball fits more to your game?
I think my game can translate to wherever I go. You know, I think I could play in Europe, I think I could play in China, I think I could play in the NBA, I think I could play anywhere. I just think wherever I go, my game can adapt to whatever style that is.
Last but not least, speaking about the NBA, are you following the NBA while playing overseas? Do you think that in the East would be a matter of a battle between the Sixers and the Bucks, or your ex-team will be in the mix and will put some of these two teams out?
I mean, you can never write off Boston. You know, they always have that heart. They always go out there and they play hard, and they have one of the best coaches in the NBA. So you can never write them off. And, you know, they did lose Kyrie and Al Horford, but they got a bunch of talent as well. They got Kemba, you know, have another year of Gordon Hayward being healthy, Jaylen Brown being a year older, Jason Tatum being a year older. They added Cantor, re-signed Tice. So they have a lot of guys that can continue to play well and they continue to be successful.
Did you agree with Giannis being the MVP?
Yeah. I called it from the beginning of the season last year. I called it. Anybody on the team, I said Giannis was going to win the MVP last year, and he went out and did it.